As you very well know, the Eastern Partnership has been a central project of the European Union foreign policy. I'm proud that I've been involved since the beginning in this project and still believe to this project. The Eastern Partnership Declaration, as you very well know, it was mentioned here many times, states commitments to the principles of the international law and fundamental values, including democracy, rule of law, respect for human rights and fundamental freedoms, as well as market economy, sustainable development, and good governance. It's clearly based on the commitment of the European Union to promote its values and the willingness of the partner countries to structure the reform process in line with the values and requirements of the European Union. Any withdrawal from the current commitments under the Eastern Partnership policies would mean questioning the European identity and credibility of the European Union. In this respect, I do not even see any dilemma for the European Union in this field. It is only obvious that any way backwards would undermine the European value-defined identity, the European Union's credibility, and its soft power in the partnership countries and on the world stage. Moreover, it could produce irreversible consequences for the very existence of the European Union. Over past few years, as you know, Armenia, Azerbaijan, Georgia, Moldova, and Ukraine faced tough choices. I would be happy also to join to this choices also my neighboring and Ukrainian neighboring country, Belarus, but we'll see. Only partner countries themselves can determine the level of the integration with the European Union they are willing to reach, but they were put under political or economical pressure or both from Moscow. They had to realize there was a price to be paid for the European aspiration. Ukraine is latest and most dramatic battle. And the battle we all are having is one about values. Indeed, an updated Eastern Partnership has to be much more political process than it had been till not long ago. It has to keep opportunities open to all partners. I would try to identify four basic steps which to my mind are crucial for the successful new stage in the development of the Eastern Partnership. Firstly, the commitment to common values and aims should be restated. This was successfully done a few days ago in the Riga summit. Secondly, the European Union should use the earliest possible opportunity to offer the prospect of the European Union membership to the partnership countries who adhere to European values and successfully implement them. Let me agree with Mr. Kubilis, which I spoke yesterday. If we would not do that, we would provoke Russia. If we, in this situation, would be brave, we would be successful, I am sure. So please don't provoke Russia and acting. Thirdly, every partner state has to have a clear roadmap so that the more for more principle is employed much more effectively. The greatest focus in terms of support and practical cooperation should be put on the countries that are ready to continue reforms in order to adhere to the European values and commit themselves to the first deeper association. Fourthly, the updated partnership should include security dimension. The European Union has to intensify its cooperation with the Eastern partners, offering more structured cooperation in the field of security and defense with the aim to strengthen their capacities and capabilities. Ukraine, ladies and gentlemen, specifically has a clear roadmap of the European integration, which confirms our common value system. Facilitation of contacts among citizens and free trade are benchmarks for the more rapid democratic change. I strongly believe that next year, early 2016, will be breakthrough for the Ukrainian with the decision of visa liberalization and the start of DFTA. Thank you very much.
Thank you.